Thanks for checking out Bluebeam and Burgers. I'm Troy DeGroat, and today I just want to go over the interface. 2018, they came out with a new interface, got rid of the ribbon and things like that. So I want to go over the interface, where things are at, and show you guys kind of the new layout. To start out, I just opened up a document so that all of my tools open up. If I don't have this open, you'll notice that some of those across the bottom will close as well. So I'm just gonna go and open that back up. And we're gonna start up at the top. So the review menu up here, I'm just gonna show you a couple things in here. Under preferences, this is where your preference button went. That used to be up on the upper right in 2017 and earlier. They did a really nice job of organizing the tools in here. So one thing that I like to point out to people here is under general options, I like to show full screen crosshair. That goes back to my CAD days, AutoCAD and Revit, where I like to have my cursor go top to bottom, left to right. It helps me find my cursor in congested areas, kind of all lines point to your cursor. It also helps me line things up when I'm drawing windows and things like that. So that's under review. We'll come back to this one in a second. File menu is just going to be like any other software. You've got your file, new, open, save, print, all that stuff. Same with edit, undo, redo, copy, paste, all that good stuff is in here. I'm going to jump over to batch. This is going to be in the extreme version only. Some tools in here to be able to manipulate multiple drawings at a time instead of one to one. So that's all under the batch tools. And for the most part, the ribbon that everybody's used to and missing is underneath the tools menu. So if you're looking for any sort of tool, go to tools. If you're looking for a markup, it's under the markups. So basically under markup, you've got different categories in here separated by these bars. This one is the text, and it used to be a flyout that would give you the different options for those. And then it comes into the pen and the highlighter, lines and things like that. And then it gets into shapes and clouds and so on. So this is where all your markup tools are that replaced your ribbon. And then you've got your stamps and your measure menu here. And calibrate being the most important, that's going to be at the top of the list. And then you've got all of those typical measurement tools in here. So you've also got your sketch tools, forms, and signatures all in there. So basically your entire ribbon just moved to the tools menu. So remember that. The interface that I'm going over, and when I say interface, I mean where all my tools are, what's turned on, what's turned off, is called a profile. So if I go under review profile, you'll see I have quite a few extra. I build them often. I'm just going to start out, and if you guys want to go to review advanced, then it'll kind of look very similar to what I have. So on the left panel over here, you're going to see some tools vertical. In the prior version, they were across the top, so you'd have to open up this panel, decide what tool you wanted, and then pick on that tab to be able to see the tools under here. So having them vertical on the side actually allows us to, we don't have to open that panel. We can just click on our thumbnails. Okay, so saves us a click every time we go to our side panels. Okay, so just a few that I have open in here is going to be our file axis, the thumbnails, layers, tool chest, and sets. If the tools that you want are not on here that you're looking for, simply come down to this gray area here and right click, go to show, and you'll see all the ones that are on are highlighted blue, and all the ones that are that you can turn on are not colored. So you can click on that and it's going to show up in that side panel. So you can go to that one. Okay. You can also go in and right click on the tool itself and go to attach and put it on the right side if you want to. And that's just going to throw it over on the side over here. If you don't use the tool, you can clean up so you're not overwhelmed with all the tools. Just come in here, right click on the tool and click hide. So that is the left panel. On the right panel, we've got some more of those tools. Again, if you right click and go to show, these are all, it's the same list. If it's blue, it could be on the left or the right. it's on, and that's what it's indicating. So you can go over here and turn on whichever ones you want as well. So I'll turn on Studio. Properties is already on. I like to have my measurement tab over here as well. So it's up to you guys kind of how you want your layout. I like to have my tool chest over here so I can get to any tools that I use a lot. And then over on the right side, I can have my properties or my measurement tab open at the same time. Those are my most common panels, so I like to have them on opposite sides to be able to use those at the same time. Okay, so to minimize those, I'm just going to click on those blue lines. And then across the bottom, I'm going to show you the panels down here, but first I want to make sure that they're turned on for you. So if you go up to Tools and go down to Toolbars, I want to make sure that these top three are turned on, your status bar, navigation bar, and properties. The status and the navigation bar are going to be across here at the bottom. And this is where you're going to split screen, vertical, horizontal, change from full page view where you've got the scroll and the pan to scrolling pages, which is going to maximize the width. And then your center wheel will scroll up and down on those pages. That's where that's going to be. And then all your navigation through pages is going to be here. So down here, I like to have these four turned on by default. We've got snap to content, snap to markup, the reuse command, which is going to reuse your tools until you hit escape to stop it. And then synchronize views. That's going to, when you put the drawings next to each other, revision A, revision C, when you navigate in one drawing, it's going to move in sync on the other one as well. And I'll put a link to a video here for compare and overlay with a tip. And so you can see that in action and if you're doing a lot of compare and drawings. So, okay, the last one I wanna show is down here, there's another blue line. And here is your markups list. So this is where it's gonna record an itemized list of all of the markups that you do up top. Okay, so as soon as I do a highlighter, it's going to show up in my markups list. Okay, lots of different workflows you can do with that. That's your interface and where things have kind of moved to. So hopefully that gets you a little bit more familiar. I will say that the more custom tools you use over here and build, and the more you use the My Tools to save your most common markups, the less you're going to come up here and go into the generic markups up, you know, under the menu. So same thing with Measure. Even with the ribbon, I didn't use the measure ribbon up top. I've always had a habit of going over to the right side and clicking on my measure tab. And all of those measurement tools are across the top here. And you have the big calibrate button as well. So maybe that works for you. For most people, it just takes a couple hours of really being in it and finding those tools, remembering where they're at. I know a lot of people that don't use it very often, they have to relearn it every time. So just take some time, get used to it. I actually really like it. I think it's the new layout is very organized. It makes a ton of sense. If I'm looking for a tool, I go into tools. If I want a markup, it's under markups. So hopefully you guys like this video. Make sure that you like, subscribe, and share it. Thank you.